A more than 5 years in the making, a single continuous multi-use trail that links Sebago Lake to Portland's East End Beach will officially open this weekend. The 28-mile Sebago to the Sea Trail connects six communities: Portland, Falmouth, Westbrook, Gorm, Standish, and Windham. News 8 Steve Minich is live from Portland's East End with a closer look. Steve.
Well, Tracy, the official dedication is tomorrow morning right down the hill behind me at East End Beach. It begins with a morning bike ride and hike. It's followed by festivities that go well into the afternoon. Now, as you will see, there is a section of the trail that is not complete, but the folks who've worked several years to make this happen say it's close enough.
Work on the trail is done. You can open it to the public.
Jamie Parker's had a busy week securing more than 60 signs along an 8-mile stretch of trail through Portland. It's the final leg connecting the 28 miles from Sebago to the sea.
It's the culmination of several years of hard work and a great collaborative partnership.
A partnership including Portland Trails and nearly two dozen other organizations, agencies, and municipalities. Will Plumley chairs the Presumpscot Regional Land Trust, which has spearheaded the five-year development.
The idea is that you've got a trail that goes a long way from Sebago to the sea. There's a lot of places to access it and walk the section that's nearest to you or a section you've never walked before.
Essentially the sum of several sections.
So it's really identifying existing routes and then looking at how we could stitch them together.
The one continuous trail links already established trails with land acquired mostly through easements and donations. Other supporters include the Bicycle Coalition of Maine.
And this is the sort of thing that encourages people to walk and ride their bikes more regularly for recreation, health, and transportation.
Though its official christening happens this weekend, it'll still be more than a year before anyone can trek the entire length. The trail still includes a 5-mile gap over the Presumpscot River that, for now, needs to be paddled. But those in charge point to history.
Since before recorded history, Americans have been traveling back and forth between Sebago Lake and Casco Bay on foot in canoes. And if it was good enough for the Abenaki, it's good enough for me.
By the way, that 5-mile gap is between South Windham and Westbrook, but again, it should be open by next summer. Live in Portland, Steve Minich, News 8.